Hi, I'm Maureen Andrew, and this is... No, you're not supposed to
Grant,
make any noise.
No noise.
Ah.
Start over.
You know what I mean? Getting a sense of the yard and just me sitting here.
Send me some loving. Send it, I pray. So far away. Send me your picture. Send it, my dear, so I can hold it. Pretend you are here. Can't you send me your kisses? I still feel safe.
Hi, I'm Maureen Alligue, and this is my husband, Jeff. And today we're very excited because we're going to go take a visit and see an old friend of mine, Bobby Terso. And I met my friend Bobby Terso about 20 years ago down at Town Hall in Patchogue where I worked, and he worked as the custodian. And this is a little picture of what it looked like at the time, many, many years ago.
What about this?
Well, that was one of the things that attracted me to Bobby. This was his car that he drove to work. He adorned it with bumper stickers from all the political parties, and he was really into being a Republican. And I encouraged him to play his guitar at some of the Republican functions, and that turned into him becoming the Lone Republican Ranger.
There's that first picture right there.
The first pictures I took of him coming out as the Lone Republican Ranger with his guitar on the steps of Town Hall.
So it says, "The Lone Ranger rides again. Return with us to those thrilling days of yesteryear." This is a shot of him around that same time.
Yeah, probably, yep. He took that himself. That's in his basement.
Sure, look at that basement, huh? He was concerned about losing some weight, he said, before we came out. He wanted to drop about 10 pounds because he wanted to be able to cinch his waist to how it was back then, which I believe he had a 24-inch waist. This here is one of hundreds of envelopes that he sent through the years. As you can see, he wants to make sure that it gets to us, so he puts plenty of postage on there in a sort of an orderly fashion, which I like. On the back of every one of his letters, there's always the phrase, "Deliver, de letter, de sooner, de better," which is nice. And also his Kong is coming, and the new John Deere that he has there. He's very into tractors. I believe there's a lot of them on his property, which is nice. So we're real excited to see him today. We're going to go and take a visit with Bobby Terso, and we'll see you over at the house. Yeah.
See you down there.
It's going to be good. The fact that somebody could live in this world that he lives in for as long as he has is remarkable to me, and somehow, you know, live a somewhat normal life. I mean, the guy, you know, had a job, is retired, has this great pension probably, has made a lot of money that he spends on tractors and Superman outfits and guitars, and, you know, lives in a world that's a cooler world, I think, you know, stuff that embraces the ideals of the 50s and early 60s, when rock and roll was cool and life was in black and white, you know, and that's the world he lives in and has chosen to live in all these years, and I just think that's amazing.
This is our friend Paulie.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Yeah, I just want to show you something real quick.
The John Deere.
Yeah,
look at that.
I mean,
that's beautiful.
Wow. So anyway, that's my ride. And there's, remember, Maureen, look back there. Don Zimmer, Hennessy, all the...
I was just looking at some of those pictures. You got them blown up big. I only have little ones of those. Yeah.
Whoop.
Oh, we got to get a shot of everybody.
Yeah, you too. This is Jeff Value's Christmas special, ladies and gentlemen.
He'll probably... Yeah, it is. There you go.
This was brought here in the middle of winter. It was 10 degrees, and we hit it right. It was all rusty, so we hit it fast with paint.
and it froze right into there, and we left it ever since.
It looks fantastic. Cool.
This is from Greenport.
Well, that's tremendous.
And, so it's a privilege to be here, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jeff Ayers' Christmas show.
Christmas special, 20 years in the making.
And of course, we did our wash today.
It's yes.
Oh. Cut the outfits out.
It's awesome. There's gold buried over there. It's got a little acre.
God's little acre. Look at that.
This is just real quick. This is, again, more of what you already saw.
Oh.
This is in case we ever need a spare.
Oh, so you do decorate for Christmas. You put all these guys
yeah.
out front of Christmas time.
But
yeah.
these are... But, of course, my other stuff is in the garage.
Oh, how fantastic. Look at that.
And,
cool.
What do you see downstairs? God, if you ever showed up at that John Lennon memorial,
they'd shoot me.
They'd say,
where?
Yes. I know.
So, you see the three drain pipes? If it's heavy raining,
oh, you got to get it away from the house.
It shoves it up
okay,
out of the house.
Yeah. That's cool.
Now, I'll confess something to you. I've been holding back. You know, you're telling me to come out. I told my friend, we were on the Patchogue Hotel 1958. We were on in those days it was WPAC.
Jack Ellsworth?
He had black hair in those days.
Yes.
And we did Lonesome Mayhem. Well, all right, come this way.
That's the bike. This is
my new bike.
Look at the bike.
Yeah, I'm going to buy rollerblades this week.
Look at this.
Be careful on those, though. You don't hurt yourself.
This is my,
Where do we put these? Oh, you sent me the good one of that, a smaller version of that.
Yeah.
Has she ever been back yet?
No, not yet. I'm waiting for, I got all those. And,
look.
The only thing is, we're changing the name. Seal is now Rosie McCullough.
You talk to him every morning?
Yeah, when I have breakfast.
When you have breakfast. That's Jack Napier.
Oh.
The Joker.
This is a music teacher from Blue Point.
I used to work with Bobby, too, at the town years ago.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. This is my Santa. This is my Christmas tree.
Oh, man, look at this.
And,
this is a holiday.
No. And Jeff's my husband over here. He's a music teacher.
Oh, hello.
He and Bobby.
These are my friends.
We play guitar together. How are you? It's good to see you.
Good to see
got a
you.
Beautiful
Maureen, look at this. My friend, my boss, Jerry Palermo.
Oh, Jerry Palermo.
Jerry Palermo.
Got the newspaper arrested. Too, yeah.
All my friends, besides John
well,
Powell.
You got a lot of them, yeah.
Hello, John. And if Teresa's out in the audience, you were it, boy. These are my neighbors.
Love Cornette.
She lives across the street.
Oh, that's
I just called her up and said you were coming.
Oh, good, okay.
That's Elaine Acurlo.
Yeah, she's
oh, that's a good shot.
And she works at the UN building. That's now, if you talk about Elaine, look at this right here. Spitting image of
Lois Lane.
Oh, Lois
yeah,
Lane.
The original.
Yeah.
You know who that's from the TV show, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, those are great.
And there I was up in...
I
was in the armed forces, though, up there. So I was in the real world for a while.
Well, no, this is the real world. I'm sorry.
Avita Duarte.
Remember
yeah,
her?
She's the
and I did kiss her once, Jeff, so I'm not a total
I remember. I remember.
And there's Cynthia.
For a while.
And,
oh, look at what's the shot with the top hat and the tux?
Oh, well, let's, we did another music show with Cynthia Hernley. This is the bedroom. I don't use this, though.
All his nice photographs, memorabilia. He keeps it tidy, which I like, nice and clean. Bit of a minimalist, which is kind of nice. You know, just the just what's necessary. Look at that. That's a good hat.
All right, now we're gonna go down to the Batcave, ladies and gentlemen.
That's the classic picture, the one that started all this, and that was before business hours. You wrote on it.
Yeah.
We did that, so you didn't get in trouble.
That's right, because you never know. Of course. Now, there's a George Washington bed back there. Go take a look.
Okay.
It was made by hand. Oh. All right, I'll go get it.
Oh, this is beautiful. Another cork on this. This is, wow, cool. I don't even know where to look. This is just too much to look at. I don't know these people. This is when he was religious for a while there. I guess this is the sacred room.
This is yours.
This is my present
this
from you?
This is an extra large.
This is the Superman?
Super outfit, brand new, yeah.
I'm going to have to get into this before we start playing.
Now, on behalf of the Red Triangle Gang, this is an Elvis watch.
Oh, man!
Oh, man!
He all dared right. to rock.
Hey, someone's going to help me with my cape.
Oh, man, you look so cool.
I need the belt cinched. Can you cinch the belt?
I'll do it. Let me do it?
Yeah. Hey, Bob, do we have more light down here?
Oh, that's about it.
Do you have any bulbs, like those
flash
bulbs?
Well, I had those right over there. Those are old. Well, Jeff, you turn them on.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, you could fry an egg in a half hour.
Oh, yeah.
Those old lights are dangerous.
He bought it 20 years ago, and he saved it for me to play today. It's been that long. As you can see, it's, I believe some of the tags are still on it. But I think this is the first, this is the maiden voyage.
Chet Atkins, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! That's a lead guitar, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, I feel like we're with Joe Gergiola and that lead guitar. Have you seen the new reunion?
Oh,
with
yeah.
It? Woo!
Holy cow. Back in the, 58, when things were really cooking, we had Little Richard, you had Fats Domino, Elvis, yeah. Of course, you know. What was it like around here then?
Was
it cool?
Well, those four that you just mentioned were it, and Chuck Berry.
Chuck Berry, yep.
But they were all king of rock and roll, you know, you'll say, oh, this one. And also, on Tavis Smiley.
Yes.
There was a nice black entertainer the other day, he says, no, it's all been done. The good, you know, like Jackie Wilson.
Oh,
they used to
God.
Call him the Black Elvis.
He was a
great. He's in a tuxedo. You know who's terrific, though? If you ever see, like, the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis in 1951, and that Louis Prima and Keeley Smith.
Love Louis Prima.
Oh, my God, are they fantastic. Yep. And sometimes they'll show you documentaries on Las Vegas. Dean Martin, they called him the Rat Pack.
The Rat Pack, yep.
And incidentally, he never drank either. Ladies.
No, he faked it.
That was his...
It was his shtick.
Yeah.
He pretended to be drunk. Yeah, that's right. The other guys were drinking, though.
Jeff and Maureen got married last fall. They had a little Grant Jr.
Married, by the way.
Oh, well, that was 1969.
69 you were married.
Yeah.
Nice. And you have how many kids?
Three
kids now. Wow.
Now I have two. Rita went to heaven 2 years ago. She got killed in a car accident.
Oh, man.
And my third daughter. Well, Jeff just saw my third daughter.
Yeah, a picture of her.
She's in a super outfit.
Where do they live now?
Out in Imperial, Missouri.
Missouri.
Yeah. And her husband just got back from Baghdad.
Wow. So you've been, how long have you been in this house for?
Oh, since 1951.
51, oh yeah. My God.
I would like to say hello to Pete Poulos. He's in heaven right now. He was in charge. Jeff, I could have been on the Brookhaven Entertainment Committee back in 1977.
Yep.
Carl Cantone, King Creole, and her name was Adelaide Silkworth. She was just as beautiful as Donna Benacci.
Ooh.
She ran the whole senior citizen division, entertainment. Pete Poulos used to have a clown outfit, and they used to, he was on when the cable first started. He was on television. He told me, Bob, I want to get you on the entertainment. But of course, you had to come to work. And of course, I was the supreme stay away, Joe. All right. I was also the photostat king in the town clerk office.
Remember the picture you sent me one time? It was you and a couple of girls. Who was that? Or that one girl?
Dolores Williams.
Dolores?
Yeah, she's downstairs in those pictures.
You were in between there.
And that was the double trouble. Some guys fall in love with one girl, but we got to fall for two. Double trouble we've got. Oh, yeah, yeah. And now I got a new picture of this new police lady. Her name is Renee, and she's blonde. Blonde-haired women who will take you for a trim and said it's nightlife. Oh, it's nightlife. Barbara's lips taste like honey, but she's out to get your money. Said it's nightlife. Oh, yeah. Colonel Tom Parker kept a lid on things. And, but what's going on this entertainment? And now, I don't know if we should quote, but now have you seen these brand new girls that are getting arrested on, shall we say, the Britney Spears stuff?
Or
Well, to me, they're all copycatting, and it is dumb. Where's the role model? Oh, and Antonio Banderas. He should have got an Academy Award and Madonna.
For Evita, right?
For Evita.
Yes.
They were so jealous of Madonna.
That's right. You're right. He's right. My father always says this.
If I ever got to see her, I mean...
He thought she was amazing in that.
She's terrific. She doesn't have to have anything to do with me. But they are so jealous of her, just like Susan Lucci.
Mm-hmm.
Took them 25 years to give her an Academy Award because they were so jealous of her.
That's right.
And that Antonio Banderas, he's the first guy who reminded me of Elvis, but he was Antonio Banderas.
Yes.
He wasn't portraying the look. You know, Elvis had that look.
Yep.
And of course, Mr. Presley, if you ever see the Ed Sullivan show right after he did...
Hound Dog, right?
Peace in the Valley.
Oh, yeah.
With the morning so bright, and the lamb is the light, and the night is as black as the sea, oh, yeah. Here's the Jordanes. There will be peace in the valley for me here someday. There will be peace in the valley for me. Oh, Lord, I pray. And then Ed Sullivan came out and said, this is a good boy.
There ain't nothing but a hound dog knocking at my door. There ain't nothing but a hound dog knocking at my door. There ain't never caught a rabbit, ain't old friend of mine.
It's still, I tell you. Now, it's a privilege to be here, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jeff Iyer's Christmas show. And incidentally, to get back to George Reeves, the Superman in 1951. Yes, that's what all this is. I had the Converse sneakers with the bicycle right there. My mother got me the first Superman top. And George Reeves would run, and he'd leap up 5 feet himself. He did his own stunts. He even leaped over the fence. Elvis studied those moves. Only Elvis had the guitar, George Reeves had the cape. And he looks just like Elvis in King Creole when the sideburns were off.
That's right. Oh, my God.
In fact, the only rock and roll star right now, you know, Jerry Lee Lewis, he made it. And then Little Richard, he looks just like he did. I saw him over here in Center Reach in 1983. He came out with Pastor Holohan of the Love Church. He had a tent revival, and he came out, and Little Richard said that the dangers of rock and roll, and he threw his rings all into the, and he went into the ministry. But then he came back out again and did another comeback special.
You're shaking up above every tree. Shake, darling, but you'll never shake me. You're sorry, oh yeah. Because I'm stuck on you. I'm gonna run my fingers through your long black hair, squeeze you tighter than a a grizzly bear. Uh-huh. Yes, sir. Stick like glue.
Stick because I'm stuck on you.
Right in the kitchen, right in the hall. Ain't gonna do you no good at all.
In our day, it was Ted Mack, the original amateur hour. A guy like Jeff, right now, if Ted Mack ever saw him, he'd be on the Ed Sullivan Show. Now, we understand those people are gone, but I don't understand this, and I don't know what I'm allowed to say this, but this American Idol stuff, to me, they're hurting those people. Mm. And those people that were on there are good, and they're making fun of them, and these so-called judges. It's almost like, forgive me that word, a freak show?
Yeah.
What happened to talent?
I know.
I mean, the guys with the accordion. My God, if Lawrence Welk was alive or Ted Mack, they'd be turning over in their graves.
Yep.
I say if it wasn't for Colonel Tom Parker, Elvis would have never got to New York City.
No.
I don't think it's fair to Colonel Tom Parker that these other people are saying, oh, he exploited Mr. Presley. Elvis was the greatest thing there was. And then it was Ricky Nelson.
Mm-hmm.
And why Tom Cruise didn't play Ricky Nelson, I don't understand. He's the spitting image of him.
Yeah, yep.
I was never on what they call medication, except when I had my car accident, you know. But whatever they call this stuff that these people go up in the air
Prozac
and go down.
And all that stuff,
you or mean? They, these people, they're so magnificent for a couple of days. You go, oh, ain't they so nice? Then they come off that stuff and they'll take your head off the next day.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, I was in the truck going with my best man to Riverhead. In fact, we were going to pick up More White Fence and also the John Deere tractor place. I go over there to Edwards Avenue. I says, Dave, I always believe we're going to be discovered tomorrow. We're going to get on the Ed Sullivan Show. And he looks at me and says, it's not going to happen. I said, well, now I'm really getting worried because the phone isn't ringing. But I always believed that. And you that are talented today, you just get out there and get back to doing your homework, eating your cookies, and let's get back to holding hands to the girls and boys. What happened to this, like marriages are marriages, you know, you're in your wedding dress and it's sacred. Right across from St. Charles Hospital is a stone house. That was my grandfather, Robert Burke. I have a trade, I can put your name on a tombstone the right way. Not with a gun, the sandblaster. And he owned that house and he used to take me to Radio City Music Hall and also the mall in Central Park where the Goldman Band. My uncle was a cornet player, that's classical. And Skitch Henderson was right on the stage talking to him. See, in the 50s, everybody smoked. It was Vogue, Humphrey Bogart, Lauren Bacall. And I played a clarinet too. I used to be in the band, you know, the F sharp. And somebody said, boy, he looks like the Lone Ranger with that scarf. So then I bought a white hat and I said, I'm going to get a guitar. I blow my next month pay for a slice of Texas cow. I got the hot 2-3-4 occupation G.I. blue. From my G.I. hair to the heels of my G.I. shoes. If I don't get to Fort Bliss, Texas, I'm going to blow my fuse. You ever get one. You ever get one of them days, Jeff? You ever get one of them days when nothing's right for morning to night? You ever get one of them days? You ever get one of them days? You're at the driving movie, you're with a cute brunette, counting all the kisses that you figure to get. Jeff gets closer, then Maureen says no. Jeff got one of those girls who just wants to watch the show. But on the serious side, I don't want to be going into, I got pictures from President Bush to me, and I also sent pictures of me in my Superman costume to him, so he knows who I am.
Yeah.
I was in the Republican Party for 60 years, but I don't understand. There's a thing called redeploy. That means you let the army rest. The old hometown looks the same as I get down from the train. And here's to me, man. Here's my mama and my papa. And Jerry Lee Lewis was playing. I was crying. And where is this Jeff Alley? I can't believe today happened. I'm so happy. And incidentally, that redhead across the street, I told her.
I saw her when she would come in. She come over. She was walking.
Well, she
down.
Posed up on. Well, I written a song about her.
Yeah.
The last time I saw Elaine's ankles, her nail polish was red and bright, and now I sit across the street thinking about Elaine all night. Now her husband's name is Hugh.
Yeah.
Now, Jeff, the solution to this story is very simple and true. But Jeff, I can't tell you now, because I'm going to get in trouble with you. That's her husband across the street.
You know what I want to do? A little
Mr.
bit of the...
Mr. How are you?
A very old friend came by today, and he was telling everyone around about the love that he had found, and Marie's name.
Of his latest flame.
He talked and talked,
and I heard him say
that she had
the longest blackest hair, prettiest blue eyes
anywhere, and a raisin name of his latest flame. You go.
I've got to think of the words.
I wished him well and then I said goodbye.
He was gone, but still his words kept returning.
Oh, what were they for me to do but cry?